me tell you why we're here. Business mastery. Not business dabbling, not business interest, not business stressing, but really business mastery. You've committed yourself to a 5-day process. We wanted to create a system for people that can show them how to attack their business and take it to a whole nother level in the current environment and any environment that evolves in the future. How many feel like business has changed pretty radically in the last couple of years? Say aye. So new rules of the game have shown up, and we have to adapt, and we have to figure out how to utilize those rules to actually do better than any other time. When economic difficult times occur in any economy, in any part of the world, and the world is really linked up now, as we all know, those are the opportunities where you see the transformation in businesses. The businesses, some of the wealthiest people today in this country and in North America, most of them got in the position they're in to be some of the wealthiest people in the world because of the Depression. It was a time in which they grew the most. One of the most obvious examples we all know is the Kennedys. And Joe Kennedy in 1929 had $4 million. By 1932, he had $180 million. That's the middle of the Depression. The opportunity for you to take market share, the opportunity for you to go from either a strong player to the strongest player in the industry, or to go from a place where you're brand new, you're an army of one, because we have a room here that's really diverse, and you're starting just out right now, and there are people that have been the leaders in the industry forever, and your ability to take that leadership from them. There has never been a greater opportunity in your lifetime, and that's not based on positive thinking, that's based on the fact that the rules of the game are turned, they've changed, they've shifted, and the opportunity to compete for anyone, a small business or a large business, the tools are there for all of us. So these 5 days are about how do we really master our businesses, but how many would agree no business is really a reflection of anything but usually the leadership of that business? Would you agree with me on this? Say aye. So really, mastering business is mastering whom, for starters? Ourselves. So we want to make sure in this program that we don't just sit and take notes on business and we sit kind of passively and take this in. My focus here is to make sure that you get unbelievable value. Because you've committed 5 days of your life, somebody wants 5 days of my life, they better deliver. Because we got to deliver for you. We're not here to just have a rah-rah session. And if you're going to get the most out of this, you're going to have to step into this right now with a whole different mindset than you do almost anything you've ever done before. It's not, I'm sitting here to learn or to, you know, can I apply that? As was said earlier, you want to take notes, you want to immerse yourself in this in a really physically active way that's different than the traditional way you've learned. You want to take notes as if you were going to teach this to someone you love, like your associates, your family members, your partners, your kids, all the people you're taking this home to because you're going to want to. Don't take notes about what you think you'll use. Take notes on everything because some of this stuff is going to show up in another stage of your business and you're going to want to have that. So our commitment is to make that happen. It's a good challenge and I'm excited to do this. I'm also challenged. My excitement is I know what's coming for you and you don't. You're going to be learning from entrepreneurs. Some of them, by the way, are attending this program. Some are coming in for their stages to be able to teach here. But this room is filled with people that are that army of one, one person just starting it. There's a few of you in this room. And there are people in this room that are running multi-billion-dollar businesses. That's the diversity we deliberately created in this room because the core issues around mastering a business, while the game and certain strategies or tactics may change, the core doesn't change. At different stages of the business, you need to focus on different things, but certain elements are sacrosanct. They can't be ignored. They can't be, you know, you can't put yourself in a position where you fail to be on top of them. That's why some businesses grow like crazy, and then they lose some of those fundamentals later on. They get overconfident, and you see those businesses take a huge hit. And we've seen that recently, haven't we? You look at a company like Lehman, been around 158 years, billions in assets. 4 months later, what were they? Bankrupt. I mean, who would have guessed in a million years? You know, look at a company like AOL. Remember how dominant they were? They owned the internet. Now, if you got an AOL account, please don't share it with anyone. It's embarrassing, right? But didn't they own it? And they lost it. I mean, they had more money, more resources, more dominance than anybody else out there. That's because the game has changed. So what we're here to do is make sure we deliver. Our excitement is we know what we've got. My other excitement is who's in this room. So you got these people just starting their businesses. You got businesses in this room that are, you know, 5 to 10 million. You got 50 to 100 million, multi-hundred million dollar a year businesses in terms of gross revenues and billions. We got Tony here from Zappos. I mean, Zappos is an unbelievable story. One of the best companies in the world to work for. You know, depending on which magazine you read, they're in that top 10, 20, or 30, depending on the magazine. And I was there yesterday at Zappos. I got a chance to go because they're based here in Vegas. At least one of their organizations are, a portion of their company is. You see 800 people that are on fire. And there's an energy. You walk in, it's not like walking anyplace else. It's the most fun place you could possibly work. Nobody wants to leave. They're excited to be at work in the morning. They're passionate to meet customers' needs. They're on the phone talking to somebody. They go, we don't have that product, but you know what? Let me find it for you. JCPenney has it. Go to JCPenney on this street and go get it. Because if we can't get it for you, we're going to deliver for you. It's an amazing culture. And guess what? You know, in less than 10 years, they're doing $1 billion in revenue. They dominate the shoe market online, and they're no longer a shoe company anymore. Tony's going to speak here tomorrow afternoon as well. But you get a chance to see what they've really become is a company. It's like Amazon might be the discounter that'll sell you everything, computers, right? They'll sell you books, they'll sell everything. This is the company Zappos that's got so much customer service, so much value they're adding in knowing who you are, that they're able to do now kind of what Amazon was doing. They're broadening. They're doing clothing, they're doing utensils, they're doing computers. But you say, how can they do that? Because Zappos is becoming like Virgin. They're becoming a larger brand, and they're finding a way to meet customers' needs like nobody else, and they don't have the discount to capture that customer. So we're gonna learn about those strategies. But Tony's in here to learn. What the heck is he doing sitting in this class? Shouldn't he just come and speak? Because the reason he is where he is, the reason Zappos is their team is constantly never-ending finding what is that cutting edge? They're staying hungry. What do we do to go to that next level? That's what these 5 days are about. We have a group here, some of you from North America may not know, but from Mexico, Homex, multi-billion dollar company, the number one home builder in Mexico. They build 140 homes a day. A day. So we're gonna go from people that are just starting their company making chocolate or bras to people building, you know, the internet or, you know, building the largest number of homes. They're all in this room, and that's what's valuable here. We're gonna learn from each other. We're gonna lay the foundation today. And part of the challenge that I've got is, how many have been to one of my events before? I'm curious. Wow, quite a few of you. So most of you know, like, the shortest program I do is like 50 hours, 5-0, you know, in a weekend, total immersion, because my whole approach is, everybody talks a good game, and people say, oh, I know this stuff, but if you're not doing it, you don't know it. You may intellectually understand something, you may have heard it before, but hearing it before is not the same as doing it. Repetition is the mother of skill. You gotta do it again, and hear it again, and experience it again, and what I do in an event is we go into immersion where we're doing the things again and again until it gets in your body and becomes automatic. So now you're really following through instead of just intellectually understanding something. It's a different level of mastery. That's what we're gonna do here as well, but here we got 5 days, and we got 19 speakers, so my job is, I own you today. My job is to give you a foundation today that will be the filter for everything else that you're doing. It'll be the thing that helps you understand where to look for the problems based on where you are in your business. It's gonna help you orient yourself to who are you in your business? Who do you need to be in your business? It's gonna orient you towards kind of answering what I consider to be the five most important questions of your business. Kind of taking stock. Because from that foundation, you know, today my associate's gonna get up here, Chet, in midday, and he's gonna take you through what are the real strategies, not tactics, but the strategies that create just explosive growth. The companies that go from zero to 100 million, or a billion, depending upon the industry. The ones that can grow, what are the common things that they're doing? We're gonna work on those today as well. And then we're gonna explode over the next few days into a format of immersion. We're gonna bring you the best of the best, bite-sized chunks. You're gonna capture like crazy. Take these tools so you can apply them and take them home and make things work. So if we're gonna master our businesses, if we're gonna take that on, it doesn't just happen, especially today. So I've had the privilege, I never got into business because I was like wanting to get a business. I was a guy that had these dreams of I wanted to help people, and then there was no distribution channel. If I'd been a great singer, it'd be easy. If I wasn't kidding myself, large distribution channel. My business, it was books, that was it. And that's what most people did, they wrote books. So I had to build the distribution channel. I kind of helped, you know, start to create an industry. I definitely created the coaching industry. No one was using that term or approach. In fact, I did it for about 10 years before it caught on. Right around the time I was about to stop calling what I did coaching because I didn't want to be a motivator or a guru. A coach is not better than you. A coach, you might, you know, Michael Jordan had a coach, I remember, and he quit when that coach quit because Jordan was better, but the coach could see things he couldn't see because he wasn't on the court. He wasn't in the forest. So I'd like, you know, coaching is it. I'm not better, but I know certain things and I can help. That was my approach. And all of a sudden, everybody in the world was a coach. Psychiatrists were coaches, financial people were coaches, everybody's a coach. But when I was a coach, it was based on results. You only paid for results. Now everybody just calls themselves that process. But I built an industry. And then gradually I got into business and I built 12 different companies and radically different industries. I built the, you know, the top spa and resort in Fiji, Namali, number one in the country there. Started with just nothing and built it up, 525 acres into something that's just exquisite. I got, you know, from that business, I decided I want to help people with their health. I got in the nutraceutical business and took on Twin Labs and turned it around, if you know that company, and Metabolife, a whole series of other companies that we did a roll up in. Got in practice management, built one of the fastest growing companies in practice management, Fortune Practice Management. I built the educational firms and companies I'm a part of. I built a little TV business. I've been where I was at the edge going, how do we survive this week? Who's ever been there in your business, right? And like your guts are ripped out of you. And I've been there when I was on stage doing an event at the Continental Center. And you know, I got 13, 14,000 people in the room and we're rocking the house. And during the stretch break, the guy comes up and goes, my company went public that day. And he goes, your stock is worth $400 million. $500 million almost. And I'm like, good day. You know, I've also been there when the stock market was crashing going, well, what the hell's happened? We lost $100 million in the last 2 days. I mean, I've been through the cycle. And in the end, it's never the damn money anyway. It's the sense of mastery. It's the sense that what you do can change or impact your customers' lives, your clients, internal and external, the people you get to work with, your family, right? Because sometimes that really becomes your family. It's what you can create in the world. What business mastery is about is how do I take a vision that I got in my head and make it real? How do I take the invisible and make it visible? And how do I sustain that and grow it? Because almost everybody can get to a point. But keeping that point is a whole other level. You heard the statistics earlier, if you don't remember them, how many businesses make it? In the first year, how many are gone? Almost 50%. 5 years, it's 80%. 10 years, it's 96%. 500,000 new businesses are created per year. 500,000. At the end of 10 years, there's 20,000 of them left, 4%. And by the way, those are the numbers from good times. So it could be even different today, right? Think about it. That's recent 3 or 4 years ago. Things haven't shifted. So we're talking about something that's exciting, challenging, it never stops. It causes you to have to grow. And by the way, as you grow and change in your life and your goals and vision changes, it affects the business, unless you completely leverage it. And some of you right in this room, you got into business and you want to master business, and your whole goal is, I'm getting into business so I can have more free time. Clearly, when you see someone talk about that, you go, they don't know what it is to run a business. That's like saying, I'd like to have a child so I can have more free time. It doesn't work that way, right? So this mixture of emotion is going to require a different energy. So my point is simple. I'm going to ask you right now from this point forward to say, if you're not going to master this, we're going to go with immersion. We're going to go with energy. We're going to go with activity. We're going to respond. We're not going to sit passively. How many up for this? Say aye. Now, if a leader affects a business, how many agree the leadership of a business shapes it? Say aye. What affects the leader? His wife, good sir, very nice. Her husband. This woman just slapped him and goes, her husband. Now think about this. Your ability to master yourself is the first game of mastering your business. Because otherwise, you gotta think about this. Whatever influences you tends to influence whoever you're leading, which then tends to influence the business as a whole. True? So we gotta look at it. What's influencing you most right now? How many of you in the last 12 months have had a gut checked or a sphincter check, whatever proper terminology you would use, around your business because of major shifts in the economy? Who's experienced that in your business here? Say aye. Almost all businesses have. I get stopped in the street every day. I got barbers talking to me going, what do I do? And billionaires, literally. One of my clients, I've been coaching for 17 years. He's one of the top 10 financial traders in the world, in the history of the world. This is a guy who in 1987, when the stock market crashed by the largest percentage at that point ever, and everybody's freaking out, he made $500 million that day when everybody else is freaking. Then he lost money for the next 4 years because he went beyond what he'd expected and it messed up his head, and he didn't perform and lost money. So he's been my client for 17 years. He pays me $1 million a year, and I'll tell you that to impress you, but it impresses me. No, but he pays me $1 million a year plus a piece of the upside. He's obviously not looking for motivation. What he looks for is strategy. He emails me every day, 5 days a week. I've worked with all the people around him, George Soros, all the people. I got a chance to study what they did, what he did, to find his patterns. And his patterns are always changing. He has to respond to a change in the marketplace. In order for him to succeed, though, he can even know what to do. But why do most people fail in business? Because they don't execute it. And the reason they don't execute it is state. If fear takes you over, all your decisions change. True or false? If greed takes you over, does that happen also, yes or no? Yeah, you start thinking it's gonna be great forever, I can do no wrong, and you start doing everything, taking huge risks you haven't really thought through, you got challenges there too. So my job with him is to really keep his psychology straight, as well as make sure his strategies and tactics are adjusting to the environment in an ideal way. You gotta do the same for yourself. You gotta say, I gotta know what's influencing me, and here's what's influencing you, two forces. First, I'll say this. If you want to influence someone else as a leader, you have to know what's already influencing them. Business is a game of influence. Think of it now. If you can't influence your people, you can't have the impact that you want. If your people can't influence, you're going to influence clients. Peter Drucker said, business is only two things, really, at its essence. It's innovation and marketing. You got to keep innovating, creating something that's better than anybody else has got. Right? You gotta be able to add more value to the customer than anybody else is giving. And you gotta be able to market it. You gotta convince people it's the best, it's the thing they're gonna use right now. That's all of business. All the other pieces, accounting, all the other things are critically important, but they're supportive of the two cores of your business. If you account perfectly, but you don't innovate, you don't keep finding a way to add more value to the customer, you're gonna be gone. If you innovate, but you can't market it, you can't bring it where people want it, forget it. That's business. So what manages you, though? Two things. If I want to influence somebody, I got to know what already influences them. Two things influence a person. Number one is the state they're in. And while you're standing, I want you to think about this, because you're going to have to manage your state if you want to manage other people's. Think about it. Who here has ever snapped at somebody, had nothing to do with that person whatsoever, right? It was just the state you were in. How many of you have ever done this before? Say I. Who's ever been snapped at unfairly? Say I. Now I got all the victims as well. Make sure we took care of that, right? But we all have done it, right? It's just the state you're in. So state influences people. Do state influence customers, yes or no? What's the biggest difference in our economy from not long ago? Not long ago, we had some of the same problems. Stocks were $85 that today are $5, $4, $1. When things are going well, people think it's gonna go well for ever. When it's going bad, they think it's going to go bad for, and they overcompensate with fear or greed. So you have to be able to manage your state, and you got to know that's what affects other people. And we're going to just show you a couple quick skills around that, because many of you have been to my events, many haven't, and we've got to unify ourselves. It's like we got to get the foundation laid so we absorb everything else, because will your state affect what you use, yes or no? Yes. Second thing that's going to affect you is your blueprint. Moment to moment, what you do is based on your state. Long term, it's your blueprint. Your blueprint is the shorthand word I use for your beliefs and values and your rules of how life's supposed to be. If your blueprint says, I can't do this, you're not gonna do it. You're not gonna find the way. If your blueprint says it's over, the economy's gone, then even if you put your heart into it supposedly, you're not gonna follow through. Our blueprint is our rules about how life's supposed to be, how business is supposed to be, how other people are supposed to be. Many of you get frustrated with your people because they don't match your blueprint. They shouldn't be that way. Well, you can shit all over yourself, but they're still gonna be that way. They shouldn't be that way, they are. Your job is to pick better people. Your job is to learn how to enter their world. Your job is to influence them. Business is influence. You gotta be able to change their state, influence their blueprint. That's leadership. Let's take a look at what this is all about. We start out this morning trying to get you in a state ready to learn. I want you to make sure you keep this state. So kind of anchor it in your body, really nice and strong. But now let's focus on what we're gonna do these 5 days. Yes, business mastery starts with yourself, but what really turns around a business? I mean, what are we here for? We're here so you can have some business breakthroughs. You don't wanna just do better. You don't wanna just grow your business a little bit. How many came here, you really came for some breakthroughs? Say I. Then the question we gotta ask ourselves is, What creates a business breakthrough? Really, what does that? What's the force? We've seen businesses, Disney years ago was in a position where it was a company a couple decades ago where it had actually gone down. Company was getting green mail. It was getting to a point where it looked like it was going to be broken up. And Disney came together and they brought in a leader, a guy named Michael Eisner. And now he's been gone for a long time, but at the time he entered for those couple of decades, what happened to Disney? Overnight, what happened? Explosion, business breakthroughs. Stock doubled, tripled, quadrupled. Because the man made certain decisions that changed the business. Think about it. You can look at any business, and if you want to know what shifts a business, what shifts your life, there's one force: decision making. Decision making is the force that shapes destiny, personal, corporate, business destiny. How many of you can think of decisions that you made years ago, one or two decisions, 5, 10, 15 years ago, that decision, you may not have realized at the time, but that decision was one of the most important decisions of your life. You'd made a different decision there, you'd gone a different direction, your life would be completely different today. Who can relate to this in your life? Say I. The secret then is getting darn good at making more effective decisions. Now, by the way, are we always going to make the right decision, yes or no? Absolutely not, no way in a million years. But most people don't have the guts to make the tough decisions because they want to make the right decision, so they make no decision. And that's a decision. Isn't it true? And what happens is the world takes them over. So decision-making is the power. Now, there's three decisions you're making every moment of your life and of your business. And you're making it right now in this room. And if you're watching here on film especially, you might make some decisions because you're not in the environment that's different. But the first decision you're making every moment of your life that affects your life and business is, what are you going to focus on? Because whatever you focus on, you're going to feel. So as a business owner, every employee you have each day comes in and they make decisions about what to focus on. Some people focus on their own needs. Some people focus on the customer's needs. Is that going to change the quality of what your business does? How it does, yes or no? A little or completely? Completely. Some people focus on what they can't control every day. Can you predict, if you're focusing every day on what you can't control, how you're going to feel about your life or your business? You're going to be overwhelmed, you're going to be depressed, you're going to be frustrated. Right now, you're deciding what to focus on. You're going to be focusing on, okay, we're getting into it now. I got the energy. Now we're going to get into the meat of this. You're right. All business is decision-making. Better decisions, better life. Or you could be saying, wow, my neighbor smells after all that jumping up and down. Notice that focus. Right? Whatever you focus on, you're going to experience, though. True? Now, some people make a decision, and then they focus on the decision about how it didn't work out versus what they learned. Because there are going to be plenty of decisions that don't work out. In fact, probably, if we were honest, most of us forget them. But most of our decisions aren't necessarily the right decisions if we make gutsy ones. But the ultimate decision is the ability to choose again. So focus is a decision. It's happening right now. It's happening in your business. But here's what we're looking for. There's a pattern of focus. At some stages in business, as you're going to learn today, the focus of the entrepreneur in the business is increasing sales. And they increase sales. And when they're successful, they eventually fail. Because their sales are increasing, but what's not? Someone tell me, what's not? Profits. Some people are totally focused on profits. Can you make any company profitable, yes or no? Sure you can. Cut enough stuff, you can make any company profitable for a while. A day, a week, a month, a year, a decade. True? At different stages in a business, you must change your focus. There's a life cycle to a business. If you're going to make effective decisions, you got to know where you are in that life cycle. You make decisions differently for a teenager than a toddler. Than a grown adult, don't you? Same thing's true in a business, in your life. So if you're gonna control your life, the way you take control is by making new choices. If you don't like how things are, what do you gotta do? Change it. And to change it, you have to make a decision. And by the way, leaders make decisions. That's what makes somebody a leader. They have the guts to make the most difficult decisions nobody else has the guts to make. And they know they're gonna be wrong. But if they're wrong, what will they do? They'll know what they want, they see it's not working, and they'll do what? Change it, which means they'll make another decision, do something new, and see if it works. That's the essence of how we grow. So first decision controls your life is focus. Lots of patterns. Some people focus on what they can control. Some focus on what they can't control. Some focus on customers, as I said. Some focus on themselves. If you've made this whole business about meeting your needs, You can run a successful business, but it'll be a job. Because you'll never be able to sell it. Because if it's just meeting your needs, it's not a system. It demands your attention, your connection. It's giving what you want. But ultimately, it's not going to give somebody else what they want, so you can't sell it. If you can't sell your business, if you don't have an exit strategy, you have a job. I don't care how successful the business is. That doesn't mean you have to sell the business. But one of the most important decisions you make in business is, ultimately, if I was going to sell this, if I chose to, I have to know who would I sell this to so that I have long-term value, not just an income along the way. I have this critical mass hit. I get a multiple of my business. And most people don't have a clear exit strategy. They think, I'll come up with that someday. You got to start with that end in mind. That's got to be part of your focus if you're going to be successful in your business.